This presentation covers the key components of the GTAP database, which is a fully documented, publicly available global database containing complete bilateral trade information, transport, and protection linkages. The GTAP database provides a snapshot of the world economy for a given reference year. The current release, GTAP 11, will be covered in this presentation. The GTAP database has come a long way since it was first released in 1993. Version 1 only had 15 regions and 37 sectors, while the latest release, GTAP 11, contains 160 regions and 65 sectors. Over the last 3 decades, the number of regions has increased almost tenfold, while the number of sectors has nearly doubled. Another important feature of the GTAP database that has been added since version 8 is the reporting of multiple reference years. With each new release, a new reference year has been added. In GTAP 11, there are 5 reference years being reported: 2004 and 7, 2011, 2014, and 2017. Since we use large datasets, the reference year lags behind the release year as collection and reconciliation of the data inputs used in the construction of the database takes considerable time. Between release years, though, GTAP users can update their database to represent a more recent reference year for the countries of interest. This should be done with sensible assumptions and a well-balanced economic model so that your updated database remains in equilibrium and does not bias the results of your policy simulations. Before diving into GTAP 11, let's briefly touch on the structure of the GTAP database. At its core, for the inter-industry linkages within country, we rely on national input-output tables. These are complemented with bilateral trade and protection data, which include trade flows, tariffs, export taxes and subsidies, and also international trade and transport margins. Other international data sources include macroeconomic data such as GDP and GDP expenditures, investments and final consumption, as well as agricultural and energy data. Both domestic and international data inputs are reconciled in a consistent world accounting framework using the so-called FIT procedure, which balances the different datasets. Input-output tables are contributed to GTAP by users. If you're interested in contributing data, please visit the GTAP website for further details. Of GTAP 11's 160 regions, 141 are individual countries. This means that for each individual country, there is an input-output table based on the national statistics, which is adjusted based on GTAP guidelines. The other 19 composite regions rely on composite input-output tables that are constructed based on the linear combination of proxy input-output tables of selected individual countries. In terms of sectoral classification, while GTAP 11 has 65 sectors for each of the represented countries and composite regions, when input-output tables are contributed to GTAP, it is not required that they contain all sectoral detail. There are some selected sectoral splits that are required to be present, such as food and agriculture, energy, and other sectors, like manufacturing and services, but not all sectoral details need to match the fully disaggregated 65 sector level. In terms of I/O processing, the first of GTAP's 3 steps is to check and clean contributed input-output tables so that small imbalances are removed to ensure that tables are balanced. After this, tables are disaggregated, if needed, based on a variety of data sources. For example, when disaggregating agriculture, we rely on the cost structure based on the Food and Agriculture Organization's data. When disaggregating energy, we use data from the International Energy Agency. And for other sectoral splits, we rely mostly on the cost structure from other I/O tables that have that level of sectoral detail. Finally, we mentioned that the composite region's input-output tables are the linear combination of proxy I/O tables of the individual countries. These proxies are selected from the I/O tables that exist within the same geographical region. We use the macroeconomic data to ensure that proxy tables reflect the macroeconomy of the individual countries prior to aggregation into a composite I/O table. Apart from input-output tables, a number of other data sources are used when constructing the GTAP database. This includes international datasets on agriculture from the Food and Agriculture Organization, macroeconomic data from the World Development Indicators, merchandise trade data based on the UNCOM trade database, protection data sets using tariff data from the International Trade Center, producer support estimates from the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and export subsidies from the World Trade Organization, as well as energy data, which is sourced from the International Energy Agency. Now that we've covered a bit of background on the database, let's move on to discuss some additional features of GTAP 11. We've already touched on the reference years, geographic, and sectoral coverage. Additional advances in GTAP 11 include agricultural production targeting being made default for all countries, improved energy data processing including revised computation of CO2 emissions, energy subsidies being included in the standard release, and services trade data now being derived from new data sources. Now that we've discussed some background of the database, as well as the new features in GTAP 11, you might be wondering what the database can be used for. The GTAP database is used with general equilibrium type models to perform quantitative analysis of international economic issues. It is, of course, used with the GTAP model, but the GTAP database also underlies most, if not all, global computable general equilibrium or CGE models. The GTAP database also serves as the basis for a number of satellite extensions, some of which are listed on this slide. We have standard with the database release, a file that accounts for CO2 emissions and energy volumes data. These are used with the GTAP-E model. We also have bilateral time series trade data, non-CO2 emissions, and information on air pollution. The GTAP database is extended to account for international migration flows and remittances to be used with the GMIG-2 model. And we also have an extension that considers foreign income payments and receipts for use with the GDIME model. The GTAP Power extension expands data in the single sector of electricity to provide a better representation of this activity. We also have a land use and cover extension that can be used with the GTAP AEZ model, as well as a multi-region input-output version known as GTAP MRIO, which identifies the origin of imports by end use in each country, and can be used with the GTAP MRIO model. Finally, food balance sheets, or nutritional account data consistent with GTAP, will also be developed. Satellite extensions are developed and released throughout the GTAP 11 sales cycle and are made available, free of charge, to GTAP 11 subscribers. When extensions become available, we will notify subscribers and make announcements on the GTAP L mailing list and our social media. Thus far, we've covered what the GTAP database is, the key features of version 11, and the different uses and extensions of the database. So now let's talk briefly about how the database is distributed to users. Since the database is rarely used in disaggregated form, the Center for Global Trade Analysis offers a few types of distributions to help users aggregate the world economy. The first, GTAP Ag, is a graphical user interface for use with Windows that is designed to load and handle multiple GTAP databases. With an increasing number of database versions, each with their own reference years and satellite extensions, GTAP Ag is an incredibly useful tool for users. The second type of distribution is called FlexAg and is a command line data aggregation program used for creating aggregated databases from the fully disaggregated GTAP database. FlexAg uses a batch file to run a series of GEMPAC executable files. This is largely used by those wanting to modify the GTAP database to aggregate their modified data. Lastly, starting with GTAP 11, we release GAMS Data Exchange, or GDX containers, with the disaggregated data in the format consistent with the GTAP model, version 7. If you'd like to read more about the database, there are two streams of documentation you can explore online. The first is through the Journal of Global Economic Analysis, where an overview of database construction has been published. Additional documentation specific to different parts of the database can be found on the GTAP website. And as always, when using the database, please be sure to properly cite it, using the citation listed on screen. This citation can also be found on the JGEA and GTAP websites. If you're interested in purchasing GTAP 11, please visit the pricing page listed for further details. A link to the order form is available on that page, as well as the main GTAP 11 page on our website. In a previous slide, we talked about how data is contributed by users. Those whose data is accepted for inclusion will receive free access to the final version, as well as all interim releases of the version to which they contributed. This is a great opportunity to contribute to GTAP and receive a free copy of the database in return. Lastly, we do make older versions of the database freely available on our website. This includes releases that are at least 2 versions old, as well as any satellite extensions specific to that version. If you have any questions on purchasing or contributing data, please email contact@gtap.edu. If you're interested in additional learning resources, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel where we house videos on different aspects of the GTAP database and model. Earlier in this presentation, we touched on contributing data and also updating the database reference years. Those 2 videos in particular are certainly worth exploring. Finally, if you're interested in formal training, we encourage you to explore GTAP-U, which is the educational arm of the Global Trade Analysis Project. GTAP-U offers courses from introductory level CGE modeling to advanced courses on specialized topics related to GTAP. For more information, please visit the course catalog on our website. Thank you for watching this presentation on the GTAP 11 database. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact the Center for Global Trade Analysis.